Hello, I'm Mr. Arlinger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. He came in 1469 and preached gospel for 150 years through five more lives. Still the darkness could not be comprehended. And then our father comes himself in the name of Gobind Rai, Royal King Gobind Rai, and with his consort are Shakti, Holy Spirit, called Mahadevan. And they organize the third and the fourth panth, our communities of religion. For details, you can read my book or watch my videos on YouTube. So here I'm doing a gospel according to Saint Matthew 7 verse 15 to 20. Jesus said to his twice born laboring solitary brethren stroke friends called Talmedim are six, and not the once-born natural disciples of the crook rabbis who disciplined them through the moral laws of Moses. Because we are not under law anymore after John the Baptist. They did what their rabbis told them to do. Thus Saul, being the disciple of Rabbi Gamaliel, did obey him obediently as required of him, and persecuted the laborers of Jesus, but in his own heart or subconscious he was not happy for the disciples doing what their rabbis tell them to do. They are called spiritually blind with no freedom or free will. In India, you know, the Bhakt Namdev, Saint Namdev said, Hindu Anna, that Hindu is a blind person because they do the same as the Brahmin tell them to do, as in Middle East their rabbis told them. So similar system, you know. Thus the substitutes, disciple and Lord, are the corruptions by the Messianic Jews to set up the same temple system from the yoke of which Jesus set us free by giving his own life as the Lamb of God. Are these robed, hireling, dog-collar priests in the churches of Mammon have fulfilled Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus, the first anointed Christ of our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. So beware of false prophets who come to you in the sheep's clothing, but underneath are ravenous wolves. Remember that angel of Israel, John the Baptist, was the last prophet, Elijah, Luke 16 verse 16, that law and prophets were till John, and no more law after him, and no more transgression or sin, but blasphemy comes from your heart. Christianity is of heart and not of the dead letters, because Christianity is of his word, which is called logo. And logo, you get it through logical reasoning. You have to do it yourself, logical reasoning. I can't do it for you. I will do the logical reasoning, and you have to listen to me, and you have to think yourself, then ponder over it, and then you preach gospel in honor of Christ Jesus. Jesus, after feeding the 5,000 people, he said, you can't preach gospel to a hungry person. So he fed them well. And then he said, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. Eating the flesh of Jesus means what came out of the mouth of Jesus, you should eat it with this spiritual ear. These are spiritual ears. This is a natural mouth. Natural mouth. What you eat, it comes out next day as toilet. You don't want to touch it. Smelly. Opposite. You eat it with your ear, spiritual ear. Take it to your heart. Ponder over it. Digest it with the teeth of logical reasoning. After understanding it, then you preach gospel with authority in honor of Christ Jesus, because you learnt it from Him to glorify our Father. We don't glorify Jesus, we glorify our Father only, which is inside us. Me and my Father are one. This is the temple of God. It's a temple of God. So far, I'm not a greedy person. I don't cheat people. I'm not a liar or other thing. That's why Peter killed Ananias and Sapphira, because their temples were not of temples of God, but temples of Satan. They have kept back money knowingly. If sin or transgression against the moral law in ignorance. That's why in John 9, when Jesus said that these blind guides are the guides of the blind, one of the Pharisees overheard, you call me blind? He said, now I know that you are not blind. And if you do things wrong, then you are doing it knowingly. When you do it knowingly, it's called blasphemy. It's greater sin than the moral sin, spiritual sin, which is blasphemy or hypocrisy, that you are hypocrite. So Jesus was killed by the hypocrites. Jesus died for the Jesus died exposing the hypocrites, not for the sinners, as these Bible people have put down, you know. These dog collar can only exist so far you have sin, because to judge you whether you are a sinner or not, you need a man. Because it's a law, transgression against the law, as in the court, you know. If you are found by law, if you are taken to the court, then there is a person called judge in the court who will then decide whether you are guilty or not guilty. Same way, if they call you a sinner, then you have to be decided by a priest who will proclaim this man is a sinner or not. But only if there is a law. But there is no law after Luke 16, verse 16, after John the Baptist. He was the last prophet. Prophets are whip master for the rabbis. No more rabbis, no more law. No more rabbis needed to judge. So we are royal priests. We are our own judges. And our laws are written over our hearts, not in the books. That's why St. Philip said, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die, because his laws are written over his heart. He goes by his heart, freedom, and not by any book, you know. That's why Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, he did not go by the book. He just went by his heart. And he saved the lives. Letter killeth, spirit giveth life. So Luke 16 was said, there is no need of a prophet after him, but the royal priest, the very sons of God, the Christ. The sons of God are Christ, to preach gospel. Gospel is preached by Christ. No Christ in your heart, no gospel, but dead letters. That's what is written here. So Christians are people of the book. They are dead. Let the dead bury their dead as they do it in the universities. They have no idea of Christianity. I go to Oxford University and I ask them that John the Baptist said, I am baptizing in water. One coming after me will baptize you in Holy Spirit. So John the Baptist never baptized anyone in water, anyone in Holy Spirit. And I'd ask them, in whose name he baptized them? They have no idea. So they have, you can see how the things have been changed and people are just reading and all that thing. So you have to be careful, you know, what you comes from your mouth should make sense, and it is what comes from your mouth that matters, not what is written in this book or that book. So Christ are living preachers of our living Father inside me, called Emmanuel. By their fruits you will know them. Do people pick grapes from thorn bushes or figs from thistles? That is, vet everyone in Holy Spirit, common sense. Just so every good tree bears good fruit, and a rotten tree bears bad fruit. A good tree is one who is led by, who is sealed to serve God, or who is led by Holy Ghost. So here it is. So this is the good tree, and this is the evil one, which when they go for mammon, Juda Iscariot went for mammon, he was evil tree. So that's why Jesus said good tree always bear good fruit, because they are sealed to serve God. So, good in to preach gospel, by their fruits you will know them. Do people pick grapes from the thorn bushes or figs from thistles? That is, vet everyone in Holy Spirit, common sense. Just so every good tree or of Holy Ghost, you know, bears good fruit, and evil, rotten tree, evil-spirited people like Juda Iscariot, who was a thief, stealing money from the purse, bears bad fruit. That's why Ad-Granth and St.Photina, they were killed because they were hypocrites. They sold their property, they kept back money knowingly, not under ignorance, knowingly. So knowingly, they came to Peter and told him falsehood. But Peter, being the very Spirit of God, he could read the matters of their heart, and he killed them. So rotten trees are not allowed into the church. Today they are full of churches because these dog-collar priests themselves, they are rotten trees. They are hireling, working for mammon, and pretending that they are men of God. If they are men of God, then they should receive wages or reward from our Father, which is gospel prayers, and not this mammon. If you know the tree by the fruit, gospel, then you know which one is good and which one is rotten. A good tree, one sealed to serve God of Holy Ghost, cannot bear bad fruit. Nor can a rotten tree, evil father like Juda Iscariot, a thief, as these hireling dog-collar priests in churches are, the Juda Iscariots in sheep's clothing, who steal money from the church donations. You know, people donate to the church purse, and they steal money at the end of the month as their salaries. So they are not shepherds who are devoted to sheep, but they are thieves, wolves in sheep's clothing. So bear good fruit. Those who are, you know, are sealed to serve God, they bear good fruit. Ask them what these people, you know, dog-collar, ask them what Yeshua stands for. Yeshua is made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua means Adam. So the firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother, Joseph foster father. They have no idea of such thing, you know. Thus, if they do not know Yeshua, how would they know Christ, the very Son of our supernatural Father? No way. Every tree that does not bear good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire as in the sectarian riots that is happening today in Syria, Iraq, Iran, India, Pakistan, all over they will be happening. And you will see how they will kill each other. Only places where it will not happen will be in the jungles, African jungle, where their people have tribal mark on their faces. They are the plant planted by our Heavenly Father Yahweh. They will survive. Every plant which my Heavenly Father did not plant will be uprooted by the roots. That will happen. So by the fruits you will know them. So by fruits you will know the sectarian riots, then show their fruit, bad fruit, and they will die. Those who are of good fruit, they live in peace, in harmony with nature and with people, everything. And they do it in African jungles and Brazilian jungle, where they have tribal mark also. Our Father God bless you, and you should know that if Abraham gave a tribal mark to Isaac, which is circumcision. Only the sons of Isaac, born of that Semitic man, can be circumcised. Not Gentile, or these Europeans or Negroes, you know, they cannot be circumcised because they don't belong to that Isaac seed, or they are not of Semitic race. So you can see how much artificial fake sons of Abraham are today. That is why Stephen went to the temple to tell them, don't make fake sons of Abraham through circumcision. And they did not like him. They told his students, go and kill this man. He's stifling our business in Mammon. It's up to you. I have the gospel, but there are no customers, very few customers. So our Father God, bless you.